Good morning, it's 8 November 2012. I told you before that ICC prosecutor Fatou Bensouda is extremely low educated. In Europe we have a special recognition system called ENIC-NARICnet that is a collection of countries that participate in the recognition of diplomas, university degrees, and qualifications. When you want to work in Europe, your foreign level of education is referred to that system. So in Europe we have an ID which people are educated well and which are low educated. Well, as I said, Fatou Bensouda is extremely low educated, a non-officially recognized university. The same goes for a Kenyan ICC judge by the name Joyce Aluoch. Joyce Aluoch has studied in Kenya at the University of Nairobi. Her levels of education is extremely low. When you go to the website of that university, you read that they work together with universities from London, etc. But that doesn't make any difference. The problem is that she is a middle-aged judge who has created a curriculum for herself. ICC explains to us that she has been a high court judge in Kenya for 20 years, suggesting that she has had a proper education and a proper working experience. Well, something is going on. The Kenyan people consist of two groups. One group is in favor of bringing war criminals from Kenya to ICC prison. And another group of people in Kenya wants to judge upon their own criminals. Now you can really wonder why, first of all, a low-educated Kenyan person, Joyce Aluoch, is named a judge within the International Criminal Court. That can only be for reasons of politics, corruption in business life, or between countries and the African Union, within the UN Security Council, the UN General Assembly, the European Union, etc. When you think clear-minded, it's rather strange that a person who calls herself an excellent judge from Kenya does not want to bring war criminals, suspects, from Kenya to a court in Kenya. Why does she want to judge upon them in ICC? That's only for status quo. It has nothing to do with a professional job. So the people of Kenya have a very weak court system. Not because of their own education and their own local courts. No, but for the fact that the African Union and the European Union and the United Nations want Kenyan low-educated judges within the International Criminal Court. And as I explained to you before, the whole corruption within the African Union will result in more drone wars in Africa. The drone wars are already expanding. Mali, Yemen, and soon there will be other countries in Africa that will be hit by drones too. And that's because ICC is 50% American. That same Kenyan judge, Joyce Aluoch, will travel together with a German judge, also working for ICC, to the United States, to a university, and there will be guest speakers. And of course, again, they talk about the implementation and conduct of the Statute of Rome and the effectiveness, blah, 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 blah. No. What they do is they organize people to be lawless. And that will result in drone wars. So, the Canadian judge working at ICC is not only an insult to my European position, it's also an insult and a betrayal role for the people of Kenya, because it can be that same judge, Joyce Aluak, who makes sure in the United States that the United States is free to send drones to Kenya. The people in Kenya have to look into this for themselves. I can't do much. I can only make another video in Dutch, and I will do that. And that's because of the lobby platform behind ICC. That lobby platform, the Hague Security Delta, lobbies with ICC for cybercrime, etc. Well, drones are part of cybercrime too. You can't have drones without software, without cybercrime. So then they lobby with security companies who supply contractors. They lobby with universities, law universities, and with our ministers. And those ministers, Minister of Foreign Affairs, Internal Affairs, they lobby with the Dutch court system, rechtspraak.nl. And based on that register we have, the European Register for Recognition of Education, ENIC, NARNIC, it's forbidden for the Dutch lobby platform to accept low-educated judges within the International Criminal Court. Let me give you a very simple example that makes it clear to you. We have a company in the Netherlands, a simple business, with an employer and employees. Some employees come from Africa. They are low-educated and they don't meet the standards of the ENIC-NARIC construction. Those low-educated African persons can still have a job within a Dutch business, but on the condition that you tell the truth about their education. Why is that so important? Well, let's say that there is crime within the business. There are a few thieves, they steal your wallet, your jacket. When you go off to get some coffee and leave your desk for 15 minutes, you notice that your things are stolen by your colleagues. Well, then the victims go to the trade union and they go to the court system. In the court system, we have a rule. We have laws that line out the legal obligations of a business and an employee. No, employer, I should say, the board members, etc. They have the obligation to provide security, basic security, so you can go to the canteen or the bathroom without being stolen. When the victims of theft are in courtroom and a judge wants to know about the staff working for that business, and a judge discovers that people have fake curriculums, so they present themselves as highly educated persons, but according to our European laws and our European recognition system for education, that's immigration, etc. And the judge discovers that the people are not educated, but they are being presented as high educated. The final result will be that the victim in that case has a very strong legal position. So the business and the employer will lose that law case because they have been lying about the level of education of people within their business. Because ICC is located in the Netherlands, that simple construction for justice also rules within the international court system. Because I am Dutch. I am a Dutch person who started a law case against the Netherlands in 2007, and the lobby tries to murder me. And that lobby is our ministers, economical affairs, internal affairs, the security system. Do you understand that judge, Joyce Aluwatch, has no authority according to our Dutch court system? So therefore it's very strange that she has that high position. Because ICC is supposed to be a fair, transparent court system that also judges against European leaders. And from knowing this, you perhaps understand why I'm so worried about the fact that ICC is 50% American and we have more drone wars. It's up to the people in Kenya to expose that judge, Joyce Aluwatch, and to demand that all the Kenyan law cases are being closed for reasons of corruption. You can't, as a nation, politicians, you can't have it both. You can't say, we have a highly educated Kenyan judge working for ICC, and no, in Kenya we are not fit to judge upon our own war criminals because we don't have judges. That contradicts each other. That means that you are too lazy to do your own job. You do have the judges if you want them. You do have the Kenyan system if you want to have it, but you don't want to use it. Well, that can only be corruption. And that corruption, that type of corruption, is going to bring wars to Kenya. So please stop that judge. I shall link the website Enignarik. There you can see that Kenya is not a member of the recognition system for education. And then you have to do your own job. And again, the Statute of Rome, the UN Charter, ICC may not lobby with the UN Security Council. ICC judges travel around the world for fun. So they can travel by business class to universities. They're their lobby. I shall link the next lobby between ICC and the United States. It takes place this month, and that judge Joyce Aluwatch will be one of the speakers. Okay, people, you have to do it yourself. I can't do it for you. I can only repeat myself. If you don't do it, it's your own fault that you will be in war. And Kenya is not doing very well at the moment, isn't it? I get very little information in Dutch, but I think you are growing into chaos, and you can stop it by cleaning up the International Criminal Court. Good luck.